Yeah, cancer treatment. Well, normally now in the clinic, there are like four pillars of cancer treatment. Chemotherapy, surgery, radiotherapy, and recently immunotherapy. Well, at the end of the 19th century, you had the chief surgeon at New York Hospital, William Coley. He injected patients with bacteria to see if that would cause tumor shrinkage. And indeed, he found that, but at a great cost, because there's a huge amount of side effects that go with that.
That sounds tricky.
It was tricky. People started to find more successful immunotherapies with less side effects. But most of the current immunotherapies focus on the adaptive immune system. And we were trying to figure out how we can target the innate immune system. To fully engage the immune system to get an anti-tumor reaction, you rather have both sides of the immune system working together. And now what you basically have is that inside the tumor, the innate immune system is working against the therapy. It's working with the tumor. And that's something you want to, well, treat or prevent. Trained immunity is the core of our research. And we try to see if we could use that against cancer. In some parts of the innate immune system don't return back to normal, but they stay in a heightened state of awareness. Even at the level of the bone marrow starts to produce more innate immune cells that also are in that heightened state, and that start to circulate through the body looking for something they have to attack that's not normal. And we think that when you start to induce that at the level of the bone marrow, this could be beneficial for cancer. And that would be good for people from your lab, from the nanomedicine lab, because it provides you a target for treatments.
In the nanomedicine laboratory, we, based on Coley's vaccine, we developed disc-like nanobiologics that are coated with trained immunity-inducing molecules. So basically, we created a nanomicrobe, but a safe one. And we optimized this formulation so that we could treat tumor-bearing mice with this nanobiologic. And when we did that, we indeed saw that there was a reduction in the tumor growth. So it was an effective therapy. After intravenous administration of these nanobiologics, they circulate throughout the animal and they preferably accumulate in the hematopoietic organs, so in the spleen and in the bone marrow. And in the bone marrow, they induce an immune response. They induce proliferation of progenitors and the development of neutrophils and monocytes. These monocytes travel to the tumor and counteract the tumor growth. Yeah, we did that with mice, and then when we saw interesting results there, we also did this with non-human primates. So we saw that the behavior of these nanobiologics was preserved across species.
Right, and then that would make a clearer path to future translation to humans.
Yes.
But it's so cold and I don't know where. I brought you daffodils on a pretty string, but they won't flower like they did last.